now in my basement. And the reason is that we need to do something for that oil burner. It has been running something like maybe 15 years. And it's starting to lose the bearings from somewhere. So we need to change it. Luckily the burning oil is almost illegal already in Finland, so you are getting a lot of these sold as used. And they are not that expensive anymore as a used unit. Of course this is 2014, so this is already 7 to 8 years old unit, but it should have plenty of lifetime still with it. So let's throw this one over there and see what happens. I'm gonna start by checking that, do we have something there in that pre-filter. There's some shit, but not that much. I'm now at my home, so I don't have any special tools available, so I have to grind with my hands. For example, pressure is not available. This looks quite nice. Although there's no major problem, so I believe that the filter is then also quite okay. It was inspected when serviceman was here some couple of years ago. Let's fill the bowl with the fuel and then tighten it. Now they are waiting there to someone to step on it, and it spills all over the place. Okay, the fuel side might be quite nice. Hopefully this. The electricity is already away. We are having the unit over here, and let's take the electric cable. The incoming line is fixed. It's closed at the moment, so let's try what kind of mess we will get. have different kind of thread over here. Probably not. Looks the same, but why don't you go in there? It's missing the seal. Somebody has been there. Let's take it from the old one. Okay, it did go like that. Should we take the other one also? Just to make sure. How will this return line is going? Oh yeah, it can be that there is some fuel in this line. This go into this fitting that is in. No, it doesn't want to go. So we are taking this old one also. Having nice amount of fuel in the air. This is the reason why women like the oil heating. It's so masculine. Stink. See how those lines will go. Yeah, I'm going quite nice, so you can tighten them. The fixing of this new unit, it's a little bit different. There's there are those small conical, all these kind of screws. Let's check that how. I'm really hoping that it will fit over here. So maybe you can use that pin too. Okay, we will see if it fits with these new type of fittings. It needs to tighten the gasket between the burner and that burner head. It seems to be quite tight. Let's plug this in and see what do we get. I checked already beforehand that the fuel nozzle in this new version or this new burner, it's the exactly the same as in my current one, and the air setting is also the same. And for the adjusting, I have no tools needed. I have to go outside and check if there is some smoke coming from the chimney. But let's first try that what it says when we are putting it back to the grid. I guess it's before heating the oil, because there is this heating element for the oil. So now when the yellow light is on, it's the preheating is on. If this brochure is from this model. It looks quite much more futuristic. And then we will also see that we probably should open the oil also. It's a question that will it fire on the first time. There can be still some air trapped into the fuel hoses. And those sounds are coming from that. I don't hear that much noise from this unit, so I guess it's a little bit better now. I'm gonna go outside and check the smoke, that it's not catastrophic level. Kiitos. Mä menen käymään katolla. Siinä on portaat. Okay, how has it been? From the chimney point of view, everything seemed to be quite nice or fine, so I'm gonna still watch that this stops and then I'm going to leave to work for the next week, so this will be going on its own for a couple of days then. Thanks for watching and let's do something else next time. Bye.